Hello all and welcome to the preview of Game Week 14. So today we are going to discuss about the FPL picks for this game week. Now, as we have already told you that we are in a hectic schedule and the matches keep on coming thick and fast. And it's just a matter of a couple of days when we saw some exciting games and Tottenham. And you can see behind me, I have a Bobby Firmino poster also to mark respect of the goal which he scored against Tottenham. So today we are going to discuss about some of the differential tips which we want to give you about different players. So it would be two each for goalkeepers, for defenders, for midfielders and forwards. And to talk about this, I have Rajat with me. And Rajat will, along with me, will take you through all the picks which we need to have for this game week. So before we proceed forward, I would request you to like and subscribe to our channel. So, okay, let's talk about the goalkeepers. And for that, let me take Rajat to our spotlight center. Let's talk about the first pick. Over to you.
Russian goalkeepers, our first pick is Hugo Lloris. So he's not been a very popular goalkeeper in terms of Fantasy Premier League selections. But if you look at his FPL price, he's at £5.6. He's had 61 total points this season. In his last five matches, he's given 34 points. So I think he's a very good pick for this coming matches because their fixture difficulty you will mention is also pretty good. Apart from that, he has had 5 clean sheets up till now, and he's also had 40 saves. So if you get 3 saves for a goalkeeper, you get 1 point. So he's at 40 saves also. So I think depending upon the fixture difficulty, as you will mention, I think he's a very good pick for the coming matches.
Absolutely, as you rightly said. So in the next 5 games, he has a match against Leicester, Wolves, Fulham home, Leeds home, Aston Villa away and Sheffield away. So I also believe very strongly that Hugo Lloris would actually score a lot of good and definitely be a good pick for your team. So let's see your second player, Rajat.
So next up is Nick Pope. His FPL price is £5.4 and he's totaled up 64 points this season. And in his last 5 matches, he's had a staggering 44 points, which is a very good score for a goalkeeper. So Nick Pope, is one of the other options which you can always look at. He's also had 44 saves to make this season along with 5 clean sheets. So I think Arsh, as per the difficulty ratio, which you will, mention, I think he would be also one of the, players where people can target.
Absolutely, Rajat, you rightly said. See, so Burnley, if you can see the matches they have, Wolves home, Leeds away, Sheffield home, Fulham home. And in fact, they are one of the teams which in game week 19 would have a double game week also. So you can expect lot of points from Nick Pope. And he is obviously arguably one of the England's best goalkeeper around these days also. So again, must have in your team. So from goalkeepers, let's go to defenders, Rajat. So who we have for defenders?
So next up in spotlight is Reece James. So coming to Chelsea, Ben Chilwell and Kurt Zouma have found their way into a lot of teams. But Reece James has been under the radar and he's been doing really well. If you look at him, he has a very good price tag along with him, which is at £5.3, and he's got 54 points up till now. In his last 5 matches, he's got more than 20 points. Which is actually 22 points, so which is, pretty good for a defender. And then he also has already scored 1 goal this season and is given 2 assists. So looking at that, I think you should have Reece James in your team because Chelsea is getting a lot of clean sheets this season. Apart from that, he also has been involved in 25 shot creating actions and 6 shots on target. So I think Reece James should be a pick. Moving over to you for his fixture difficulties.
So Rajat, Chelsea is hosting West Ham United for this week, and I think Chelsea can definitely get a clean sheet because West Ham has, again, even though they have looked strong, I'm not so sure that it is very easy to score at Stamford Bridge. Next away is Arsenal away. Again, Arsenal is not in a very good goal scoring record, so you can have points there also. Aston Villa home, Manchester's City home. Again, Manchester City home, I also know it would be slightly difficult, but apart from that, fixtures wherein you can expect a lot of these points, and we do not need to forget Reece James is actually designated mostly a free kick taker along with the you know, a couple of their other players, but he's number one. If I see the number of free kicks he takes, the corners he takes, so along with Ben Chilwell, he's the most preferred one. So yes, definitely a good pick for us. Second defender, Rachit.
So next up in spotlight is Stuart Dallas. I know most of the people will think that we are picking and suggesting a Leeds defender here who's been playing very open play this time. But if you look at Stuart Dallas stats, he has already scored 2 goals this season, which is, you know, just next to Kurt Zouma, who scored already 4 goals as a defender. So I think he deserves a look in. He already has 7 shots on target and he's been involved in 18 shot creating actions. So apart from his defensive duties, he's very well involved in the attacking, you know, moves for Leeds as well. So I think we've already had a look at his fixture difficulty ratio, which you will mention. And I think he seems a very good pick.
Absolutely. So they are actually traveling to Manchester United, your team, Rajat. But I don't see Manchester United keeping clean sheet anytime soon. So he's definitely a good option. And the way Leeds plays, which is a little bit of... they would have a little bit of finesse and flamboyance about them. So definitely that is one. Secondly, they are hosting Burnley in the next game picture. Then they have West Brom away. They have Tottenham away. But and also in 19th, they have 2 games, which is Brighton home and Southampton home as well. So you can expect, he among those players to be right up there in scoring maybe goals or the chances he creates. Definitely a good pick. So now let's move from defenders to midfielders. So whom we have got, Rajat, for midfielders?
First up in midfielder spotlight, I think there is Pedro Neto. So I think Raul Jimenez, absence has been a blessing in disguise for Pedro Neto. He's playing in an advanced role now. And he already has scored 4 goals this season along with 2 assists. Apart from that, he already has 9 shots on target and 46 involvements in shot creating actions. I think that's tremendous for a midfielder, Arsh. So Pedro Neto, along with his fixture difficulty ratio being a pretty easy on the next 5 matches, I think he deserves a look in.
Right. And in fact, Rajat, if you look at the games which Wolves is playing, so they're going Burnley away, Tottenham home, United away again. We expect Wolves to at least score goals. Brighton away, Everton home and West Brom home. So I think this is a very promising fixtures for Wolves. And as you rightly said, Raul Jimenez, I think with Wolves, you have Podens and you have this guy, Neto, who actually are now taking most of the burden since now you don't have Jota also in Wolves. So yeah, a very, very good pick. And I believe he's a very strong contender to score quite number of goals consistently. Whom we have got for second midfielder, Rajat?
Arsh, I think Rashford from Manchester United has been doing really well in the last 5 matches. He's already accumulated 31 points. His season total is 66 points. Although on the price tag, he's at 9.4, but he's very, very, lesser price compared to somebody like a Salah or a Bruno Fernandes or a Kevin De Bruyne. And I think his being in the midfielders, category is... very good opportunity for players who, wanted to pick him. So I think Rashford deserves a look in. He has already got 14 shots on target and he also has 31 involvements in shot creating actions. So looking at United's fixtures and looking at their current form, I think Rashford is a must have in your team.
Absolutely. Rajat, as you rightly said, so they are hosting, as I said, United is hosting Leeds home. Leeds again, leaky defense. Not many clean sheets. Rather, I won't say I don't see any clean sheet which Leeds can keep, right? And that's what it is. Leicester away. Leicester has, they are just blowing hot and cold. Again, susceptible to conceding. Wolves home, Aston Villa home. And then they have a double fixture. And double fixture is against Liverpool away and Fulham away. That's a double game week fixture they have in 19. So, I think Rashford now is coming into his elements. And with the... I think one of the most important reasons is because now you see a lot of thrust from the midfield also. Pogba is clicking. You already have Bruno Fernandes. So it gives Marcus Rashford a very good base actually to go and actually score goals. So yes, a very, very good and a very sensible pick. So from midfield, let's go to forward. So who is spotlight targeting in the forwards, Rajat?
Ash, before I mention our targets, I'll specifically like to mention that we're trying to pick players who are not already on people's radars because, these players might find themselves not to be on, many people's wish list. But these guys have been doing really well in the last 4 or 5 games. So So starting with the first player, it's going to be Shea Adams from Southampton. He did really well in Danny Ings' absence, and now he's, you know, helping him out in the attack for Southampton. He's priced at £6 in FPL, and he's already, you know, accumulated 65 points this season. In his last five games, he's done really well and already got 31 points, 4 goals and 4 assists already this season, and involvement in 26 shot creating actions, and he's already taken 13 shots on target himself. So I think being at a price tag of £6 and looking at Southampton's fixture difficulty ratio in the last 5 matches, I think he could be a very good differential pick with his price tag.
Absolutely, Rajat, you rightly mentioned. Now, Southampton is hosting City home, but the way Southampton is playing, I do believe that they would have plenty of opportunities, because City, again, even though their defense looks slightly solid, but they look vulnerable, you know, when the teams are playing with flair. So I expect him to shine there. They are going Fulham away, again, a place wherein they can score goals. West Ham home, Liverpool home. Now, Liverpool, again, is not boasting the best of defenses right now, even they have still kept their heads even though after losing Van Dijk, but still they are vulnerable to concede. Also in the game week 19, again, Southampton has a double fixture, which is against Leicester away and Leeds away. So Shea Adams is a very sensible pick, in our opinion. I think you put it absolutely correctly. So who is the last player on the radar, Rajat, in forward?
First, last pick on the radar is Richarlison from Everton. So, looking at his stats, he's at £7.8, total 45 points this season. But in his last 5 matches, he's accumulated more than 20 points. Already scored 2 goals this season and involved in 3 assists as well. Shot creating actions, if you look at it, been involved in 29 shot creating actions, and shots on target are 13. So, this is more of a gut pick from both of us. I think he's been doing really well. And he's been fitting himself very well in the new system developed by Carlo Ancelotti. So I have a gut feel that in the next 5 matches, along with the fixtures, the kind of fixtures that Everton has, he's going to do really well, and he's going to be a surprise package.
Okay. Absolutely well put. I think, as you rightly said, it's a gut pick, because we have seen those games, you know, how Everton has played. And in fact, they've kept clean sheets also. And not only clean sheets, but I think they have looked very fluid in attack, and they play a little bit of expensive football. Obviously, we all talk about Calvert-Lewin and Everton, but Richarlison, he looks very impressive whenever he's on the ball. So Everton is hosting Arsenal, down on confidence. I believe he would contribute. Then then you would have Sheffield United away, Man City home, West Ham home, Wolves away, Aston Villa away. I think Everton should be able to put some goals across in these teams. So yes, Richarlison, with the form he is in, how Everton is now playing in the last couple of games, what we have seen, is a very sensible pick. So thank you, Rajat. Now let's move out of the spotlight and let's focus on what team I actually have put for this game week. And I'm just going to talk about, you know, there is one change which is I am going to make. So before I make, here is my team. So I have, in defense, I have Martinez as a keeper, which I think a lot of people would be having also. Balbuena, unfortunately, could not play this game because of injury. That's one of my players. Cancelo is there in my defense. Konsa again did not feature. So that's a problem with these hectic schedule. You know, you just never know if all the players are going to start. So I'm hoping for manager's press conference before I make any, you know, commitments about what kind of, players would be starting. Then I would make my changes. In midfield, I have Bruno Fernandes. Bruno Fernandes has given me blank for the last couple of games, which I'm not happy with. But again, he's a player which I would definitely persist right now. Then I have Son, who scored that beautiful goal against Liverpool and is again a player of high quality, which should definitely be there. I have Jack Grealish. Jack Grealish, again, had a lot of chances in the last game. I think they played really well, but again, could not do anything about the result. Kevin De Bruyne, I thought that he would actually give me most of my points. He was my captain in the last midweek game as well. But unfortunately, was not able to do that. Even though he created a lot of chances, he got 2 bonus points also, but not the returns which I expected. In forward line, I have Kane. Kane again, Leicester home. I expect Kane to put at least 2 goals. And I'm just telling you that he would be my captain for this for this game week. That's what I believe. I think he has a very good opportunity to score. Bamford, Manchester United away, as I've said, not the best defenses. Bamford is surely, he looks again a very good pick. And then again, I have Calvert-Lewin also, a pretty consistent player. Arsenal home should be able to score goals. So that's about my team. And let's hope we have given you enough advice and enough tips to make these changes. I know the matches are coming thick and fast, but we are also trying our level best to keep up with it. Anything would you like to add, Rajat?
I think that's more of most of it, Arsh. I think what you mentioned is that the fixtures coming thick and fast, it's very difficult to predict which players will be continuously, you know, in part of the playing 11s. So that's the beauty of this year's season, that, you know, although you might have missed out in scoring a lot of points in the earlier game weeks, but you're still always going to be in this because this is a very unpredictable year. So wishing all the best to all the, you know, listeners of our video, and we hope you get as many points as you wish. That's it from our side.
Absolutely. Thank you. Thank you so much, Rajat. And I would like to mention for the people who are very passionate about Dream 11, we would be publishing all the Dream 11 teams as soon as the lineups are announced, around 45 minutes before any kickoff. You can have our Dream 11 team in our YouTube channel as well as on our Twitter channel. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on Twitter, and I'm pretty sure you would enjoy whatever information and whatever stats we are presenting in front of you.